Hey everybody, so do you know what your best settings are for your Phantom 4 Pro or your Phantom 4 Advanced? Well, if you don't, let's just watch this video and you can find out. My name is Brad and I do drone video tips every single week. And if that sounds like something interesting for you, go ahead and click that subscribe button and follow the channel. But let's get on into this. So first of all, I really kind of hate to tell you that the perfect settings are different for every situation. Yes, you can easily just throw on the automatic settings and be fine. But didn't you just buy this 4 Pro or 4 Advanced because you wanted that camera and you wanted those extra settings? So why would you buy this camera and then just set it to automatic? That's crazy talk. First of all, you always want to check your white balance. If it's a sunny day, you want to have it set on sunny. If it's a cloudy day, set on cloudy. But what if it's partly sunny or partly cloudy and the clouds go in and out? Well, set it to 1 and just go throughout the day and you'll have to fix it in post, as they say. Fixing it in post is always fun. But I like to leave my setting at daylight if it's partially cloudy. Just, you know, when the clouds come in, it doesn't look too bad. Now, what I like to do is I like to set the ISO always at 100 because that's when you're going to get the very best detail. Now, sometimes when it's later at night or in the evening or early in the morning, you may not have an option to set your ISO a little bit differently. And don't forget, when it's really, really bright, having the ISO at 100 actually helps you out a little bit with the exposure. And the next thing is you have to set your shutter speed pretty much to 50 or 60 depending on your frames per second. You have 24 frames per second, you set it to 1/50th. You have it 30 frames per second, you set it to 1/60th. That means your ISO and your shutter speed are kind of set in stone-ish, and the only thing you really have any flexibility with is the aperture, which is why you got the Phantom 4 Pro or Advanced. Now, the other thing you can do is, of course, you can add a filter to the lens. And I already had a video on filters, so you can go check that out. To get the best exposure, you want to set it up so that your zebra striping is on, so your overexposure warning is on, and you want to set it so you can see the histogram. If you put that histogram and you have it set so it's right all in the middle, you have a really good exposure. And that is what you're looking for. Use that histogram and use the zebra striping. Now, sometimes you're not going to be able to get rid of the zebra striping because you're looking right at the sun. And then when you look lower at the ground like this, the ground is kind of dark and the sun is still overexposed. Well, in that case, you really don't have a choice. You're going to have to overexpose the sun a little bit because you're pointing in that direction. Or if you can do it, point in another direction and get the sun out of the shot. You really don't want to be doing that anyway because, well, you get overexposed shots and you will have to fix that in post. And that's an editor's worst nightmare, is fixing it in post. And of course, you can just use the automatic mode, but then why did you buy the Phantom 4 Pro or the Phantom 4 Advanced? Because it has all these, this advanced camera. You bought it because it has the camera, right? If you didn't buy it for the camera, then go ahead and use the advanced. If you bought it for the camera, you really need to use the histogram and the overexposure warnings. And of course, you can always use the focus peaking to make sure you're in good focus. Because when you have an aperture that's set really low or high, depending on how you look at it, like a 2.8 or a 3, whatever, then you actually have a little bit of blurring in the background. So you want to make sure that you have what you want in focus and you turn on that focus peaking. These are the processes I use when I'm doing video, and I'm always fine-tuning it, and I'm still working on making it perfect and every time. And of course, I'm not perfect, so whatever you do and whatever advice you have, make sure you leave a comment below letting people know what it is. And if you are looking for advice and you want some more, maybe there's something in the comments that you would like to read, and that will give you more information. If you like this button, click the like button. If you know someone who would benefit from this video, go ahead and click that share button. And of course, click the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Until next time, I want you to fly safe, and bye!